I greet you once again in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It is wonderful to have this very moment. I hope you are taking care of yourself, taking the responsibility. COVID is real, and we are sure that with God's help, we will overcome. I'm born again. The Lord has been so good to me. In our last broadcast, we talked about guarding our hearts. Today we continue guarding our hearts, and especially in marriage. We will look at Genesis chapter 39 from verse 7 following. In this text we have four characters. The first character is Joseph, who is the main character. We have Potiphar, and we have Potiphar's wife and households. And here we see Joseph coming face to face with one of the most difficult temptation a young man or a young woman can face, the sexual temptation. And the Bible says that Joseph was blessed because God was with him. Joseph was well built. That was one quality of the blessing. And like any good thing, we know good looks, a good body, a structure can become a problem. And if one uses the body not knowing that God has given you this beauty to glorify him. Many men and women in our society, we have seen they have fallen in sexual sin or in immorality because of their appearance, good looks. And they have made them desirable to others. And others have used their beauty to manipulate other people. And so in this text, we have Joseph, who we see that Potiphar's wife was attracted. In fact, the implication here is that when Potiphar's wife was attracted to Joseph, this betrays the adulterous heart. And there was so many years later, Jesus talked about this when he talked in Matthew chapter 15, verse 19, and he talked in Mark chapter 21, verse 21, that such evil of adultery comes from the heart. And so as you look at this, Genesis chapter 39, verse 7, we see Potiphar's wife. Equally, she must have been attractive. And as an attractive woman, and as we have seen, if you are attractive, everybody is attracted to you. And Joseph might have been attracted to her. But there is one quality that we see in Joseph. Joseph guarded his heart. He guarded his conscience, insisting that he cannot do this because she is Potiphar's wife. Let us look at verse 9. And Joseph said, "No one is greater in this house than I am. My master has withheld nothing from me except you, because you are his wife. How then could I do such a wicked thing and sin against God?" This clearly shows a person who is able to guard his heart against doing an evil thing against God. This shows us that Joseph could not even dare. He repudiated even the very thought of sexual sin. Given the frequent stories we hear of sexual harassment in workplaces, we hear employers sleeping with employees, married employees. We hear in universities, lecturers sleeping with the students for grades. And we see this, and the Bible strongly condemns this immorality. This behavior lack moral principles. And so, the Bible says it is wicked and it betrays the real trust of a married person. And here we see Potiphar's wife really betraying her husband. And in this scenario, we look at Joseph. Sexual immorality to a young people, this is what they call fornication. But to a married person, sexual immorality is adultery. And as we look at Joseph's side, as he resisted this sexual sin, we see in his heart, we see him, a person who fears God, a person who loves God, a person who is able to resist because God has helped him. The Bible tells us that Joseph, for sure, frustrated this woman's desire to sleep with him. And he repeatedly refused to sleep with this woman. Joseph surely knew his boundaries. As a slave, he had no otherwise. What he was commanded to do, he must have done. But unconsciously in him, he knew that sleeping with Potiphar's wife is a sin against God. And in refusing to go to bed with her, that was keeping boundaries. And another thing is avoiding this woman left a picture of a person who knows that his destiny is pegged on the fear of the Lord. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 39 verse 12b that he literally slipped and left his cloak and ran out of the house. And many people have fallen prey of this. Today we have the morning pill. We have condoms. We have so many birth controlling devices. I don't know if it were you in that situation, what could you have done? Today, young men and young women don't want to work hard. They want to take people who are already established in their life, and they are destroying. In fact, they are calling them a sponsor. And this calls for what we have been learning about guarding our hearts, that out of the abundance of the heart comes evil. If you look at Matthew chapter 15 verse 19, Jesus says that even sexual sin comes from the heart. James talks about this when he says that when sin conceives, it grows to become something big. And this is what we are seeing in Joseph. In him was hidden something that really shows that he feared God. Verse 9b says, how then could I do such a wicked thing and sin against God? Here we see the fear of the Lord in Joseph. It is only for those who fear God can resist the temptation of the sexual sin. Joseph, for sure, is an example of that young men and young women can be able to say no to sexual sin. Joseph is an example. And we have so many. Today we see young people don't believe that it is possible. In the book of Revelation chapter 3, the Bible says that be faithful to the end, and I will give you the crown of life. Faithfulness to the end means that God crowns the faithfulness of those who are faithful to him. May God bless you as a young person to be faithful. It is possible to chill. It is possible to stand firm. It is possible to remain faithful like Joseph. We will continue as we look at Potiphar and Potiphar's wife and Joseph as we look at adultery. God bless you. Let us pray. Gracious Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we want to thank you for your goodness and for your mercy. Just as we have seen in the life of Joseph, that it is possible to remain faithful even to the end. Help many of our young men and women who are challenged by the challenge of sexual immorality. Gracious Lord, we pray that you will help every one of them who desires to stand firm, that they will be faithful to the end. For this we pray, believing and trusting that you will uphold us with your word and with your outstretched hand, that you will remain faithful to the end. For this we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen. God bless you.